this wasn't even about history. And that's the thing about Atlantis. People read what they want to into it. And for the Nazis, and especially Himmler, it was a way to figure out their racial superiority, giving this pseudoscientific reason or pseudo-historical reason as to why Atlantis was so great and so was the Aryan race.
Yeah, one of the theories that's a little more accepted than those that aliens and teaching ancient civilizations is that Atlantis was in Crete. The accomplished Minoan civilization there collapsed in the middle of the second millennium BC, probably from a volcanic eruption that was on Thera, which is the modern Santorini.
Right.
So that theory holds a little more weight for some people than the more off the wall ideas.
As the aliens, which I seriously think that's my favorite one, and the idea goes that they accidentally blew themselves up with a nuclear bomb.
Oops.
It's another moral lesson about the dangers of technology, but a little bit different. Or the one that they were behind the Cro-Magnon cave paintings.
While a lot of these potential Atlantis locales sound not very hospitable, Antarctica especially, I'd say, there's one in particular that might be the Atlantis you would most want to visit, should it be true, or even if there's not an Atlantis.
Well, Sarah and I are happy to go and explore this to our fullest abilities.
And that's Bimini in the Bahamas. Edgar Cayce, who was a clairvoyant psychic, he would go into trances and read fortunes and predict things. He had a vision that Atlantis was located from the Gulf of Mexico to Gibraltar. So at least we have the Pillars of Hercules in there.
Unlike the Sweden theory.
But it was destroyed in a final catastrophic event circa 10,000 BC.
Which again puts it about where Plato said.
Or earlier, right?
Yeah.
A lot earlier, yeah. But he founded an association for research and enlightenment. And that group today has focused their efforts on the Bimini Island chain. They go on dives and search for traces of Atlantis. They actually believed that Bimini were mountaintops in Atlantis. They were really high ground and that the world's oceans were a lot lower. And he claimed that there was a record hall on Bimini that was identical to one under the Sphinx, which just sounds like a really tangential connection. And this housed all of the ancient records of Atlantis.
But it's interesting how that so many of them seem to try to tie together all these cultures that have nothing in common. Like, they couldn't have sprouted up independently of one another. They must have come from that one original source.
One civilization, right, that basically gave everyone the blueprints for advanced civilization.
And of course it must have been Atlantis. But you had said something cool that was a little bit more recent.
Yeah, just earlier this year, Google Earth launched a new underwater search tool. And so, like people do on Google Earth, they start looking around, and folks started noticing a grid-like pattern off the western coast of Africa, which of course is another suspected Atlantis site. I mean, what isn't? And the product manager of Ocean in Google Earth debunked the rumors and said that the lines were, quote, artificial data remnants left by sonar-equipped boats collecting data from the ocean floor. So that's kind of a lot of technical jargon for me, but as far as he knew, the research from those boats, or the research that those boats were conducting, was not Atlantis-related at all. It does look cool, though. I saw a picture of it. It looks kind of like an underwater street grid.
Well, and if you're looking for that kind of thing, that would be a good place to start. But definitely, you also had a really good quote that you told me earlier.
Yeah, and this is why people aren't going to give up searching for Atlantis. Richard Ellis, who is the author of Imagining Atlantis, wrote that Atlantis lives on in people's minds largely because you cannot prove it doesn't exist. You can't search every inch of the ocean bottom, and so the hope remains alive and the promise of finding treasures in sunken palaces.
It's like that pot of gold at the end of the rainbow.
Yeah.
I'm going to continue looking.
Except under all of the world's oceans.
Which is a little harder to find, perhaps. But let us know what you think about Atlantis and what your ideas are, because I talked to a couple people who actually thought that Thera was a plausible explanation. So email us at historypodcast@howstuffworks.com.
And if you're into conspiracy theories and Nazis and all that, you should check out our newest podcast, Stuff They Don't Want You to Know on iTunes.
For more on this and thousands of other topics, visit HowStuffWorks.com. Let us know what you think. Send an email to podcast@HowStuffWorks.com. And be sure to check out the Stuff You Missed in History Class blog on the HowStuffWorks.com homepage.